It was late in the evening on Saturday, December 13th, 2014. There was a junior hockey league tournament at the Lake Delton ice rink.
People have kind of been feeling sick throughout the weekend, but it was actually sort of the last night of the tournament that after the game was over and there weren't a lot of people left in the rink, one of the players actually collapsed and passed out in the locker room.
An ambulance arrived and crews determined that there was a high likelihood that that player, as well as others, were experiencing CO poisoning symptoms.
On the night of the event, folks were experiencing shortness of breath, headache, nausea, things they just kind of chalked up to the cold or the flu, like any of us would. And it wasn't until someone actually passed out that they realized something bigger might be at play here.
There were 92 people who actually ended up in the emergency departments. After this event, we did start to kind of wonder about whether or not there were possibly other events that we weren't detecting, that we weren't being made aware of. And we wanted to have a system in place to notify us of those events if that happened.
Lake Delton situation was an extreme shock to me because I couldn't believe that there wasn't some sort of detection equipment in there.
Wisconsin was one of the first states to join the tracking network back in 2002, and we've been active in it ever since then. After Lake Delton, what it really brought home was the need to have real-time information, to be notified right away, and actually having staff available to be able to begin to mount a response.
What we discovered after the Lake Delton event was that had someone been able to pay attention in real time to the data that was coming in from the poison center, we would have seen the event happening as it was happening. In collaboration with the Wisconsin Poison Center, we came up with a system by which staff at the tracking program can get that information in real time, and that 24 hours a day, someone would know if there was an anomalous number of people calling the poison center about a carbon monoxide related concern.